We now bring you the program that brings together leading personalities, representative insights, all together in a meaningful and delightful conversations as your social barometer. Let's chat with Tita Gracie. Let's chat with Tita Gracie. Hosted by breakthrough millennial boomer Gracie Venezuela. Only here on V81 Radio.
Hello, everyone. It's 6 o'clock once again. Welcome to Let's Chat with Tita Gracie. Now, today we have two mavericks in the performing arts world. These two individuals have done our country proud in so many ways, and I am so honored to have them here on the show today. And for all of you out there who are interested in classical music or who have seen some operatic productions hosted by some of the major venues in this country, these names are probably on top of your list of favorites. They certainly are on my list. First is a maverick diva, I would say, because she has been devoted to not just her own brand of performance and, you know, always being ahead of the pack when it comes to the leading ladies of classical productions in the country. But this woman has been such a hard worker, and she is truly a mover and a shaker in the field of classical music, especially in the field of opera development for the new talents, okay? She's the Vice President of the Friends of the Philippine Opera Foundation, founding and managing director and artistic director of the Philippine Opera Company. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Karla Gutierrez.
Hi, Gracie.
Hi, Karla. Welcome to the show.
Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Can you hear me? Okay.
Yes, yes.
Oh, I'm so excited. It's going to be a fun evening.
Yes. And of course, the show won't be complete today without our dear friend, another person who is a luminary in your industry. And well, this guy, of course, you know, if I were in your shoes, I would love to be in a scene with this guy, because he's the perfect complement to someone like you. Ladies and gentlemen, this guy is such a gem in the firmament of Filipino classical music. And he has been in so many stages all over the world. He's the international Filipino baritone, Andrew Fernando. Welcome to the show, Andrew.
Hi, good evening. Hi, Karla. Hi, Gracie. Thank you so much for having me. This is going to be so much fun. Talking about embracing the new normal, right?
Oh, yeah. Of course, this is the new normal now. You know, we're in our homes. We're talking to each other like everybody else does these days. Yeah. But the difference is today we have the whole world listening to us.
Right. I mean, who would know? We'll get to this point, right? Yeah, but here we are.
Yeah. So, I'll give you two a chance to greet your fans. We're reaching California. We're reaching New York. We're reaching Middle East and Europe and Australia. So, Karla, would you like to greet your friends and your followers from all over the world?
Talaga over the world. So, I would like to greet everyone. Actually, the message is stay safe, stay home as possible, as much as possible. But we really have to move on and go on with our lives. And I've already shared the link. So, lahat yata ng friends ko na, no? So, it's going to be a fun evening.
Yes, of course. How about you, Andrew?
I just want to say hello to my family and friends, first of all, here in Manila, and also to my second home, which is Los Angeles, California. To my friends and family are watching, hello, be safe. And of course, another place that I lived in is New York City. So hello, mga New Yorkers, and thank you for tuning in. And then in the ad, I also heard Hong Kong, right? And I also lived in Hong Kong for a while. I studied there. So hello, mga taga Hong Kong. So, like what Carly said, be safe and be vigilant, and let us be kind to one another and love one another and help one another. This is the time to do it.
Absolutely. So, Andrew, since the pandemic started, It's a good thing you're here in Manila, because you could be anywhere in the world.
Right.
And you know, and you're in Manila. So how has your life been since the pandemic?
Well, of course, like everyone else, I suppose, up and down, emotionally and then mentally also. But I think the biggest complaint that I'm getting is from my hair. Right, I haven't been to the barber, and so every time I'm being asked to do a guesting, I'm like, let me check my hair first before I would say yes. But it's been a good test, I would say, of character, being first of all in our industry, and secondly, being, you know, doing and going through this with everyone. Nobody's special. Everyone's going through it, right? And so
absolutely
true that some people may be having a harder time and some people may be having an easier time, but we're all together. That's why I said earlier, this is absolutely the time to be there for each other.
True. And how about you, Karla? How have you been since the lockdown happened?
Actually, I've been more busier.
Nice.
Because, no, it's because of film stage. We've been doing a lot of. Kaya nga natatawa kami parang hindi ko parang naramdaman yung vacation na matulog. Parang I sleep more or less now because we're doing so much paperwork with the film stage and yung with the NLEC now it's happening. So, wala, as in, yun.
And there were online shows also by Phil Stage that I saw one with Leia Salonga. I saw that one. That was really nice. And Menchu Lochenko. Yeah.
Right. I saw your show, Andrew. The Bayanihan show. I tuned in for that.
Oh, the Bayanihan Musical, of course, of Mr. C. That was Mr. a beautiful C. experience. Yeah, it was a beautiful experience, actually, during this pandemic.
My house was full of your voice that night.
Oh, I hope in a good way.
Yes. You know, for a change, instead of the usual stuff that I listened to that night, was completely Andrew Fernando all over my house. So, I tuned in for that one. Yeah, it's so seldom that people get the chance to actually experience classical music in their homes, especially from Filipino artists. But certainly with the pandemic, one of the good things that happened is that since everybody's in the digital space, you know, they have seen excellent performances of various classical musical groups and individual artists. Of course, we all know that when Andrea Bocelli sang in front of the Duomo in Milan, the whole world open their screens, you know, at all hours of the day just to catch that individual performance. So really, there is a soft spot, no, for classical music, even in the most extreme times like this, no. And I think that tonight, a lot of people who may have had little exposure to classical music or have had some, may be surprised to see the faces, the people in the production, out of their usual character, talking like, you know, like regular people about something that may some people might think to be esoteric or medyo parang hindi nila ma-reach. Pero I think because you two are here today, they will see a new face. And certainly Karla will talk about her mga alaga, the people that Karla is grooming, no? And I'm really looking forward to that. So in the next hour and a half, we are going to be talking to Karla Gutierrez and Andrew Fernando. Ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a classical night with these two mavericks of the Filipino classical music industry. Stay tuned. We'll be back in a few minutes. We'll just go for a short break.
We'll be back shortly with Tita Gracie. Let's chat with Tita Gracie, only here on V81 Radio.